So we have this hardware continuum from cell phones and PDAs to laptops to tablets to desktop computers, all the way to nodes in a data center that is providing cloud computing services. Regardless of these different manifestations and sizes, the organization of the hardware inside the computer system is pretty much the same. You've got a CPU, and the CPU is connected to a conduit, which we call the bus. And you've got memory that has the instructions and data that is needed for the CPU to execute. And the CPU can use this conduit, namely the bus, to access the memory. And you need storage for persistence of files and other data that you produce during the computation. And once again, the CPU can access stuff on the storage device through a controller that is also connected to this conduit. And you may have other peripheral devices like a microphone or a camera. All of these devices, of course, are accessible for the CPU through this conduit, which is the bus. And of course, in this day and age, a device has to be able to communicate with the outside world. You have a network, and once again, the network is interfaced through a controller to the CPU via this conduit. So this conduit for communication, which is the bus, serves the purpose of connecting the CPU to the memory as well as all the I/O devices that it may need to interact with in order to do whatever the intent is of the user and the application that they want to run on the computer. And depending on the sophistication of the device that we're talking about and the speed of the device that we're talking about, these controllers that I'm showing you may have different capabilities. So for instance, a network controller may have the ability to move the data directly from the memory into the network or from the network into the memory. And this, as you may have learned in a computer organization course, is called direct memory access for the controller to move data swiftly between memory and the I/O device. And similar DMA facility may exist in the controllers of other high-speed devices. Disk is another high-speed device. So that's the capability that you've got for some of these controllers. Some of these controllers may be slow enough, for instance, a keyboard or a mouse, that the CPU can directly query new data that is coming from the controller that is associated with slow-speed devices and move it into memory or use it in any fashion that it wants.